Let's have examples. When it fell off, number 2, number 2. It says squiggly legs A and B are such that the probability of A is 1 over 5. Then likewise, the probability of B is given by 1 over 2. Then they say that find the probability of A union B if from a number 1 or part A and B are independent events. They say part A, find the probability of A union B if A and B are independent events. We say that if A and B are independent, it simply means the probability of A intersection B is the same as probability of A times probability of B. This on simplifying will give us 1 over 5 times 1 over 2. This will become 1 divided by a 10. And then secondly, they say find P of A union B. From additive rule, we saw very well that the probability of A union B, this becomes probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Now this one, on substituting B, I would say the P of A, it is 1 over 5, plus P of B is 1 out of 2, minus this one, it is 1 divided by 10. Apply both marks first, this will give us, this is 2 plus 5, that is 7 divided by 10, then minus 1 over 10. This, on simplifying, I will get probability of A union B, as this will become 6 over 10. Yeah, 6 divided by 10. By 2, this is 3. By 2, this becomes 5. Giving us answer 3 divided by 5. But part B says find the probability of A union B if A and B are mutual exclusive events. Now in this case, when they say A and B are mutual exclusive, it implies that the probability of A intersection B will give us a 0. Therefore, from additive rule, this part will vanish to 0, and thus we shall have the probability of A union B as probability of A plus probability of B alone. This, on simplifying, will give us 1 divided by 5 plus 1 divided by 2. This is 2 plus 5. That is 7 divided by 10. That's our final answer. Let's have a second example. 2009. Paper 2, number 1. This one says that if A and B are independent events, they say if A and B are independent events, then Roman part A says show that events A and B complement also independent. Show that A and B complements are also independent. Please take note, if A and B are independent, it simply means the probability of A intersection B. This becomes probability of A and this probability of B. Now this one, to show that these two are also independent, meaning I have to show that the probability of A intersection B complement. This becomes P of A and P of B complement. This one is our proof that I want to get. But to get this one, what I'll do, I'll begin with this left hand side. The probability of A intersection B, now complement, of course, from set theory, this one shall become probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. And this will give us probability of A minus, already A and B are independent. Because these two are independent, if I go back, it implies this one is same as that, giving us P of A and P of B. Now from this one, ask yourself, what is common? Of course, P of A is common in two what remains, it is 1 minus the probability of B. Now this one will give us probability of A. Now this one will give us the probability of B complement. And thus, I would say, Therefore, the probability of A intersection B complement this very one shall yield for us the probability of A times probability of B complement. Thus, A and B complement are also independent events. There is part two, it says find probability of B given that. They say find, Roman number two, find the probability of B given that the probability of A is at 0.4 and probability of A union B is 0.8. Now, of course, in this case, I have to use the additive rule, which says that the probability of A union B is the same as probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Now this one, we simplify further, it will become probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. But because A and B were independent, expand this, giving us P of A times P of B. But it say find P of B. What I can do, I can select the probability of B be equal to X. This one, it is known as 0.8. Is equal to this one, it is 0.4. This one, it is an X. Minus this one, is 0.4. That equals an X. This comes this side, giving us 0.4. Is equal to this is the 1. 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6x over 0.6 over 0.6, giving us x as 4 divided by 6. This one can simplify to 2 thirds. X will become 2 divided by 3. But what was our x? Our x was P of B, and therefore the probability of B is given by 2 divided by 3. Question 10, number 2, number 1 says two events M and N are such that we have two events M and N such that P of N is equal to 0.7, comma, then probability of N intersection N it is a 0.45. Then they say that and the probability of N complement section N complement this is 0.18. Then they say that find number one probability of N complement and number two the probability of N or N but not both M and N. Now for this one, what you will do, they say M and N are events such that P of N is 0.7, P of M, the section N is 0.45. What you can do, begin with this very one here. You recall Morgan's rule. We say if this intersection will give us a union, therefore on simplifying this, the probability of N complement, the section N complement, this will become probability of N union A, all of it complements, which will become 1 minus probability of N union A. But this one, we know it as 0.18 is equal to 1 minus the probability of N union A. This will come this side, this goes that side, leaving us P of N union A as 1 minus 0.18. This will simplify to this becomes 0.82. Now likewise, they say find this, meaning from additive rule, from probability of M union N, this becomes probability of N plus probability of N minus probability of N intersection N. On substituting this one, we now know it as 0.82 is equal to this one, it was 0.7 plus this one, it's not known, minus this one, 0.45. Thus, I would say this becomes 0.82 is equal to, if I subtract this minus that, I'll get 0.25 plus 0.8 plus P of N. This comes this side, giving us gravity of N as 0.82 minus 0.25, giving us 0.57. But they are saved by P of N complement. The probability of N complement becomes 1 minus probability of N, which becomes 1 minus 0.57. This on simplifying, I'll get minus 1, 0.43. When they say find probability of M or N, they are meaning M union N. But in this case, they say but not both. Like, for example, if I consider a Venn diagram of this kind, we have this and that. I have this and I have that. This is P of N, this is P of B. Of course, this is probability of A intersection B complement. This is probability of A intersection B. This is probability of A complement intersection B. Of course, all of this one is a union. When I say probability of A or B, this means A union B. But when I say A or B, but not both, I would say it's this plus this only, but not both. So it implies here, for this case, when I say probability of N or N, but not both, not both, this means I'll add probability of N intersection N complement plus probability of N complement intersection N alone, but not the intersection of this. And therefore, this one, on simplifying, this one shall become probability of M minus probability of M intersection N, plus this one shall become probability of N minus P of N intersection N. Thus, on simplifying, I'll say the P of M was 0.7. Intersection was 0.45. The P of N was 0.57. Minus P of N intersection is 0.05. And thus, this one, on simplifying, will give us 0.37 as our answer. 2011, number 2, number 4, they say two events A and B are such that the probability of A complement intersection B, this is a 3x, comma, the probability of A intersection B complement, it is 2x. And then they say the probability of A complement intersection B, this one is given as an x. Then they say the probability of B, it is given as 4 divided by 7. Then they say use a Venn diagram to find from a number 1 or part A the value of x. Now in this case, the Venn diagram is a bit easier. We will draw this as our Venn diagram. We have this and that. We have this and we have that. This is probability of A. This is probability of B. This one means B only, which will become a 3x. This means A only, which becomes a 2x. Now this one, it is 4 divided by 7. So I can find this intersection by subtracting this minus that. 4 over 7 minus 3x. Then this one is the part outside. This, that one. And then they say find the value of x. Putting in mind, if you add everything here, I must get a 1. And therefore, I can easily say that all from these specific facts, the probability of A complement, section B complement, this will become probability of A union B, all of it complements, which will simplify to, of course, this one we know it as an X. This can become 1 minus probability of A union B. This will give us X equals to 1 minus open bracket. A union B is all this one. But this one alone, it is 2X plus all of this one is 4 over 7. So I'll simplify the brackets, giving us X is equal to 1 minus 2x minus 4 over 7. This one will come this way, giving us 3x is equal to 1 minus this, 3 divided by 7. And multiply times a third, times a third. This will cancel, giving us x equals to 1 divided by 7. They say find the value of x. After getting x, to find anything else, I'll first draw my vector diagram again to make simplifications. So I have this, and I have that. This is probability of A. This is probability of B. This was 4 over 7. This is 3x. 3 times this, it is 3 divided by 7. Now, this one here, if you replace x here, will become 1 divided by 7. This is 2x. 2 times this, it is 2 divided by 7. This is 1x, which is 1 divided by 7. But they say that part B, find probability of A intersection B. Of course, it is this, will give us 1 divided by 7.